Kia ora and welcome to worship at St. Mary by the Sea today. Today our theme is the Kingdom of God, and we look back at the year that has passed and contemplate how our walk with Jesus is going. If you have a celebration or a milestone you'd like to share with us, please email office@stmary.co.nz and we'd love to be able to include it. Jesus, as you walked along the lake, the shore of people's lives you called. May we respond.
Jesus, you called others to bring people to your message.
May we likewise bring others to your message. Jesus, you call us to worship together.
May we with one heart and one voice worship you. Source of our rest,
we do not always rest in you. Source of our strength,
too often we rely on our own. Source of love,
we struggle to show love to others. Source of hope,
sometimes we despair. We are sorry for the times we have not trusted in you. Help us to put aside the things in our lives that pull us away from seeking you.
And know that no matter how far you go, you can never go beyond the love of God. You are forgiven.
Amen. Lead us into the light of your rest, strength, love, and hope.
Jeremiah chapter 23, verses 1 to 6. The Lord said, "You leaders of my people are like shepherds that kill and scatter the sheep. You're supposed to take care of my people, but instead you chase them away. So now I will punish you severely and I will pay for your crimes. I will bring the rest of my people home from the lands where I have scattered them, and they will grow into a mighty nation. I promise to choose leaders who will care for them like real shepherds. All of my people will be there, and they will never again be frightened. Someday I will appoint an honest king from the family of David, a king who will be wise and rule with justice. As long as he is king, Israel will have peace. Judah will be safe. The name of this king will be the Lord Gives Justice."
This is a reading from Colossians chapter 1, verses 11 to 20. His glorious power will make you patient and strong enough to endure anything, and you will be truly happy. I pray that you will be grateful to God for letting you have part in what he has promised his people in the kingdom of light. God rescued us from the dark power of Satan and brought us into the kingdom of his dear Son, who forgives our sins and sets us free. Christ is exactly like God, who cannot be seen. He is the firstborn Son, superior to all creation. Everything was created by him, everything in heaven and on earth, everything seen and unseen, including all forces and powers, and all rulers and authorities. All things were created by God's Son, and everything was made for him. God's Son was before all else, and by him everything is held together. He is the head of his body, which is the church. He is the very beginning, the first to be raised from death, so that he would be above all others. God himself was pleased to live fully in his Son, and God was pleased for him to make peace by sacrificing his blood on the cross, so that all beings in heaven and on earth would be brought back to God.
A reading from Luke 23, beginning at verse 33. When the soldiers came to the place called the Skull, they nailed Jesus to a cross. They also nailed the two criminals to crosses, one on each side of Jesus. Jesus said, "Father, forgive these people. They don't know what they are doing." While the crowd stood there watching Jesus, the soldiers gambled for his clothes. The leaders insulted him by saying, "He saved others. Now he should save himself, if he really is God's chosen Messiah." The soldiers made fun of Jesus and brought him some wine. They said, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." Above him was a sign that said, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals hanging there also insulted Jesus by saying, "Aren't you the Messiah? Save yourself and save us." But the other criminal told the first one off, "Don't you fear God? Aren't you getting the same punishment as this man? We got what was coming to us, but he didn't do anything wrong." Then he said to Jesus, "Remember me when you come into power." Jesus replied, "I promise that today you will be with me in paradise."
On Christ the King Sunday, or the Reign of Christ Sunday, or the Kingdom of God Sunday, we look back on our lives and we ask, how are we measuring up? How's our walk with Jesus going? Are we living the ways of Jesus? The Lord's Prayer, while simple and memorable, is incredibly radical. And every time you pray it, you are asking for God's kingdom to come on earth as in heaven. And these aren't comforting words, they are challenging words. They challenge us in what we're doing. Are we living heaven's ways or some other way? This year, have we brought the kingdom of God a little bit more fully on earth as in heaven? In Luke chapter 10 at the beginning, we hear Jesus send out some disciples. He sent them out ahead of himself to be dependent on those they went to. The idea being that they wouldn't take their wealth and their ideas, but instead they would need to eat and listen to those they were going to show respect, and to discover how God was already working in the midst of those they went to. Jesus' kingdom was built as he walked along the lakeside and through the countryside, calling people to journey with him in the ways of God. He was a humble carpenter, not a prince or a king of a wealthy kingdom that you have to abide by or suffer his wrath. Instead, you have to choose to leave your ways behind and to follow Jesus to be in God's kingdom. No one's forced into it. You're not coerced, conscripted, or drafted in. Jesus' kingdom is accessible to all, and it grows as people choose to live God's humble ways through following Jesus' teachings, to welcome the stranger, to feed and clothe those who need it, to care for others, not just ourselves. The Beatitudes, or as Caitlin calls them, the beautiful attitudes that we've been reading, set out the character of people who are living the ways of Jesus. They show us what our attitude should look like. Their challenge is to allow Jesus' teaching to continue to shape and reform us away from our selfishness into the shape that God calls us into. Jesus realizes how hard it is to consistently live his teaching. And in the middle of the Beatitudes in Luke's Gospel, he stops and he says this. This is Luke 6:46. Why do you keep on saying that I am your Lord when you refuse to do what I say? We need to choose whose kingdom we're part of. Are we part of the world's ways, where the vulnerable are pushed aside by the strong? Or are we part of Jesus' kingdom, where we live his ways of love and selflessness rather than selfishness, where we live Jesus' ways of hospitality, forgiveness, and second chances rather than cutting someone off or out, or of Jesus' ways of loving those who trouble us, not just those who love us back? When we live Jesus' ways, then a little bit more of God's kingdom comes on earth, as in heaven. The beautiful attitudes give us a picture of an upside-down kingdom where the vulnerable are cared for. And it is this that we celebrate on Christ the King Sunday. It is a place where the voiceless are heard. It is a place where the vulnerable are cared for. There's no protecting special interests. There's no power or glory or prestige. There is only servanthood and humility. There's no surrounding yourself with powerful people to get your way. Jesus didn't do that. Rather, he surrounded himself with the vulnerable and the marginalized. He worked against the social norms. He ate and drank with the gangs and the prostitutes. He accepted women as disciples in a time when women weren't allowed to be taught. He empowered people who, up until that point, had little or no power. And of the kingdom of God was here, he said. He also said the kingdom of God was still to come. From what I can tell, until Jesus comes again to judge the world, the kingdom of God only comes as we live it. Our challenge is to live it, and may God's kingdom come on earth as in heaven. Let us pray. Jesus, you taught us how to live as part of your kingdom. Please give us the grace and courage to do this. In your name we pray. Amen. We pray in silence for those things and those people on our mind. Now, as Jesus taught us, we pray together, saying,
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. May we be gentle with ourselves, remembering that we are created in the image of God. May we go into the world with honesty and thanksgiving, embracing tears, laughter, and all that is good. May the protection of God comfort us. May the courage of Jesus sustain us. May the tenderness of the Spirit embrace us. Amen.